Hello YouTube, this is BWaterloo9 with the review of the Razer Carcharis. I bought the Astro A40s, the Razer Carcharis, and the Siberia V2s, and this is by far my favorite headset. For sound whoring, I think that this is the best headset that you're gonna get. I haven't tried the Sennheiser PC360s. A lot of people say that that is the best headset, but I think that the Razer Carcharis is actually going to be the best for sound whoring because of the fact that the headset has little to almost no bass. So when there's explosions or gunshots going off, it's not really that loud in your ear, but all the noises are louder than they are on other headsets. The headset's very light and comfortable. The ear pads are a soft cloth, as well as the headband. And it's very adjustable. It goes really high. If you just had some huge head, this headset would still fit. One thing that can be uncomfortable though is that it goes on your ears instead of over them. The headset doesn't really have a lot of features. The only features on the cable are the volume control and a mute. You really don't need anything else than that, but some of their headsets have some cool stuff like being able to mute the game volume. The mic on the headset isn't bad, but there is a couple downsides with it. When using it on Xbox Live, sometimes it doesn't pick up the greatest. You might have to talk a little bit louder, and then it usually picks up your voice until you're done talking. And the other thing with it was when I plug it into the colored 3.5 jacks on my computer, it has a loud, very loud white noise sound, and I could not get rid of it. The only way that I got rid of it was by when I got my mix amp plugging it in through that with the USB, and it fixed it. And it wasn't just my computer because I also tried it on two other laptops and both of them did the same exact thing. So it is the headset. Not a big deal, but it can get annoying. But as for the sound quality and everything, the sound quality is great. Everything sounds crystal clear. There's not a lot of bass, which, like I said, is good for sound whoring because you can turn the volume up really loud. And you know, grenades are gonna go off right next to your ear, and there's not much bass right there that's gonna hurt your ear or muffle the sound or anything like that. And the other thing is that this headset has the widest sound stage out of the Razer Carcharis, the Siberia V2s, and the Astro A40s. The PC360s, I'm pretty sure, have a wider sound stage, which basically means that you can hear stuff from a farther distance, where it's gonna pick up and that noise is actually gonna come through your headset. Like I said, out of the three, this is by far my favorite headset. But if you play anything other than Call of Duty or maybe even Halo or something where you can hear enemies switch weapons and stuff like that, footsteps, this is not the headset for you. It doesn't have anything that is going to benefit you more than another headset for anything other than sound whoring in games like Call of Duty. And you know, the other good thing about this headset is that it's the cheapest out of the three. The Astros are the most expensive, and they're actually, you know, the worst headset out of those three. Another good thing about the headset is that the audio cable is a braided cable, which is going to get tangled less, and it also isn't going to crack. I know that my old Turtle Beach X1s, I had those for a few years, and why I ended up having to get new ones is the cable had cracked because it was old and it gets real stiff. But with the braided cable, you know, it's a cloth, so it's not going to happen. And it's a lot more flexible. You don't got to worry about the wire breaking or being damaged. It seems like the only way it's going to do that is if it gets like pulled through something and, you know, pulled apart, or if it were to be cut. As far as using this headset for stuff other than gaming, for music, this headset really, it's not that good. The sound quality is good, but if you listen to hip hop or rap, a lot of the songs have a lot of bass, and this headset has almost no bass, so the songs are definitely going to sound a lot different. And that's pretty much everything about the headset. I definitely recommend it. I just wanted to update you guys too about everything that's going on with me, why I haven't been posting videos. I've been trying to get my teams more active, and we're starting to get more active. I've been having a lot of problems with recording the audio, so I haven't really had any good gameplay to put up. And I've been trying to get my stream to work. I'm about to redo my computer today, and hopefully my stream will be up. And I'll put a link in the description, so if any of you want to watch the live stream on Twitch. We also, at some point soon, are going to put out a team montage. Morph is working on editing that, and it's looking real good. And I'm also on an Xbox team right now that we're trying to get pretty active too. So hopefully, I'll be able to have a lot more gameplay for you guys, as well as streaming. I also still am going to do the review of the Siberia V2s. I'm just waiting for a short gameplay for that, and also a comparison of all three. If you like this video or any of my other videos, please comment, subscribe, follow me on Twitter, check out the Twitch when I get that going.